Hi guys, welcome to Racquetball 101. My name is Josh, on the court at 12 hours a day, Rogoff, and this is my brother, partner in crime in doubles racquetball, Jon, on the court other 12 hours a day, Rogoff, also known as, I have AIDS, Jon, I have AIDS, Rogoff. Jon, why don't you tell him why your nickname's I have AIDS?
Because in racquetball, it takes 8 points to win, and we always win.
This is Racquetball 101. Today we're going to start off by working on our swings a little bit. As you may know, there are 4 different types of swings in racquetball. There's the forehand, the backhand, the through the legs, and the over the head. Today we're going to start with the forehand. Forehand.
The thing you gotta remember about racquetball is that you don't want to do a through the legs shot until you're comfortable with the other shots that we spoke about. Once you are, here's how you do it through the legs. If you're wearing tight pants like this, which you should be, proper etiquette for playing racquetball, you gotta pull up your pants. I know you might not have time to do this, but it's important to do while you're playing. Bend your knees. Got the ball in your sights, swing, just like this.
Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back. Today we're gonna explain to you a little bit about the court. This right here is a wall. Made out of solid cement. Solid cement that they get from the finest cement places. Every court, right, if you notice on the bottom left, there's a hole, it's called the snake hole. And every court, every 5 minutes, a snake will jump out of there. He can eat your ball, you can choose not to eat your ball, in which case, if he doesn't eat your ball, you must continue to play. Alright, now let me show you around the rest of the court. If you notice, these are the foul lines. And it says in memory of Jimmy Byrne, king of the court. Every court is actually in memory of Jimmy Byrne. Because Jimmy Byrne, as you all know, actually our father, Jimmy Byrne. Jim Byrne that he'll burn you on the court, by the way. And these lines right here, the foul lines, if you hit them outside the foul lines, it's a foul ball, you get to redo the serve. Right. This is the service line. Actually, you may notice that one doesn't have that corner on it. The corner is actually... Sometimes we are so powerful that it just makes the crack deeper and deeper until we get to the Earth's core. So we have to plaster that up to make sure that, you know, the lava doesn't erupt into our court.
John, you might be asking yourselves, well, what is this little mark right here? This is, past this mark is where the official has to stand. They have to stand like this. And you might say, why are they standing on the court? Well, I'll tell you why. They're just an obstacle on the court, and that's just another facet of the game that you just have to get used to. Three officials on the court. There's an official on this side, there's an official on that side, and there's an official on the back here. Each official has 2 balls. A green one and a blue one. Sometimes you get the green one, sometimes you get the blue one. And you never know which one you're gonna get.
When an official wants to take a break, he sits down in the official break chair. Also, sponsored by official paddle balls. You'll see these things so often, even the Statue of Liberty's using them.
As you might be asking yourself, well, what kind of rules are there? Well, there's a lot of rules, and we don't have enough time to explain them. But when you break one of your rules, it's not called a penalty, it's called Willy in the Snake Hole. Because it means just that. If you break one of those rules, you gotta stick your Willy in the snake hole. And if you're a girl, well, you don't even want me to go into it. But I'll tell you what, Willy in the snake hole, it's a funny thing, unless it's you.
Jump over your player's back service.
Go. that's our airplane. We told him to fly over here right now while we were filming our video to show you what kind of champions we are, what kind of champions we own, what kind of champions we have.
What kind of champions you could never be.
Most important piece of equipment, the paddle. Why? The racket. Why? Because it's paddle ball or racquetball, whichever you prefer. Or squash sometimes. I prefer this paddle, sport craft. Why? Because it's a sport. Why? Because it's a craft, too. You'll notice, my paddle has a checkerboard finish on it. Why? So I can line up my shot every time.
You good?
Yeah.
Now I'm going to talk about my racket. This racket's made by 211-762. They have pretty much the latest technology of any racquetball racket out right now. Now you notice it has little wiener holes here, which are there to represent the court itself. And very intimidating. I have a few good stories maybe I'll share with you later. Now this strap is actually there for numerous reasons. This one is actually here for me to wrap around my neck like a necklace because, well, I'm the champion of racquetball. Also, the strap is there so that I can wrap it around my wrist so that when I swing, it doesn't burn up from the ludicrous speed. This visor was actually given me to Jimmy Byrne, king of the court, as you see over there. In the
Our dad. Our dad.
Yes, he was on his deathbed, which is actually a racquetball court. He said these last words to me. So, John, if you ever need something to keep the sun out of your eyes and keep the women around your thighs, you'll be that visor. Bright angel health foods. It's like angel food cake, but it's healthier. And he said to me, John, there comes a time in every man's life where he has to realize that racquetball is what he has to do with his life.
Thanks for joining us.
As you know, at the end of every show, we usually have a moment of silence for all of the racquetball, squash, paddleball greats.
Ira Ballstein.
William Snakehole.
Jim Byrne. Frank.
Thomas.
Phil Paddleball.
Capillary.
Capillary. That's too good. Paddleball player. Alexander.
Hamilton.
Seriously, Alexander Hamilton. Incredible.
Mr. Bean.
So it's not fun, it works on our reflexes.
Works on our reflexes. Ready, Josh?
Yeah.
All right. Until the sun.